Dear students, today we learn the line balancing. Now, this is very important topic, line balancing. The first question may comes in your mind. So what this line balancing means? You might have aware the large production volume, or we'll take some example of the assembly line, or we take the example of say automobile factory, car manufacturing, where we find so many operations are carried out on different platforms. It is also called workstations. So there are different workstations are there where different operations are carried out, and after completion of the operation on each and every product that comes on the that assembly line has completed, and we get the final product. This is the general scenario. This line balancing is basically important where the continuous flow of work and different operations on that particular product has been carried out. Now this line balancing, it is defined as the procedure for creating workstation and assigning tasks to them according to the predefined technological sequence, so such that the ideal time at each workstation is to be minimized. This is the standard definition of the line balancing. Now we'll take one example. Suppose we take example of say drawing a license. You all have your driving license. But while approaching or while going to the center where this driving license has to be taken, you find some sequence or operations. We'll take some small example. Suppose this is the first operation. You might have first given the application, and the first operation is supposed to say review of application, right? And for review of application, it takes say 60 seconds. Now for getting a license, one important factor is your eye test. So after review of application, the second operation may be say eye test. And for this eye test, say again the time required is say 60 seconds. Then third operation may be say to check or review of any violation. Check for any violation. Again, we consider it requires say 60 seconds. So this is the sequence of operations. The next operation may be say paying of fee. So paying of fee. So again, it might take say 60 seconds. So all there are four operations are carried out. Now next operation may be say take a photo. Photo. Again we consider it requires 60 seconds. For this operation, the required amount of time is say 60 seconds. So after taking the photograph, the last operation is to issue of say license. Issue of license. Again it requires say 60 seconds. Now students, dear students, while while going through this, if you minutely observe during this sequence of operations, each and every stage the time required is say 60 seconds. So we can say that on each workstation we can consider this as a work station, or we can say it as a work element. Right now station is nothing but the combination of different work elements. You will find on each work element the time required to complete this operation is 60 seconds. So we can say that the complete operation or each person performing this operation is taking 60 seconds to complete the task. So this is the example of a perfect line balance. We can say that this is the perfect line balance. As on each and every work element the time is same. No work element is remain ideal. To wait for the procedure to perform his next task. So this is, we can say, it's a perfect line balance. This is one example. Now we'll see another example. Suppose there are three workstations, 1, 2, and 3 workstations are there. These are workstations
individual workstations. And there are different work elements, say 1, 2, 3, say 4, 5, 6, 7. These we call as a work element. Now again, there are sequence of operation may be carried out, different sequence of operation may be carried out on this workstation. Now suppose to finish any task on this workstation 1, this we call as a workstation 1, this is workstation 2, and this is workstation 3. So these are three workstations. And to complete the task, suppose it requires say 3 minutes to complete the task on this workstation. The time required is say 3 minutes. To finish the task at the workstation 2, the time required suppose is 5 minutes. And say for the workstation 3, the time required say 2 minutes. Now what is the difference between this perfect line balance and this? Now you will find the time required for completing the task on each workstation is different. In the workstation 1, you will find to complete the task, it requires say 3 minutes. In workstation 2, the time required to finish the task is 5 minutes. And in workstation 3, the time required is 2 minutes. Now, we can say that this is not a balanced line, as the time required for different stations is different. So if you focus on both the example, you'll clearly get an idea what is the perfect line balance and what is the imperfect line balance. As there is some ideal time is here, this workstation 3 has to wait for the workstation 2 to complete his task. As we are already said, this is a sequence of operations. Unless this workstation has finished its operation, this workstation 2 cannot start his operation, because he has to process something on whatever the object or product or task coming to this workstation 2. So he has to finish this 6 and 7, say work element, requires only 2 minutes to finish the operation, but it requires 5 minutes workstation 2. So unless and until these 5 minutes are not completed, this workstation 3 will not start his work. So he will idle there for around 3 minutes. So if you consider in the larger scenario, if this 3 minutes ideal time, 3 minutes suppose one workstation
remains 3 minutes ideal. But what happens if we consider for a 8-hour shift or say all 3 shifts all per, we can say week, then month and the year. So how much ideal time? See the larger scenario and how much worker we have placed on it. And we, when we talk in terms of monetary money, so how much money we are spending on it. So it ultimately reflects the profitability. So this line balancing is very important topic. It plays a very important role to minimize the time and to maximize the production. Now we'll take one example again so that this will clear your more doubts. I hope you understand the basic difference between the perfect line balance and imperfect line balance. In perfect line balance, all the work element has work for the almost equal time, whereas in not perfect balance line, the work element has different time taken for completing the task. Now we'll take one example. So I will rub this. I hope you note down the thing. So before moving further, we'll see some formulas that are required while solving this line balancing problems. I hope you get the basic idea why this line balancing is important. Now we'll see some parameters that is required while calculating the cycle time, calculating the line balance. First is the cycle time. Cycle time. So how we define the cycle time? So this cycle time is nothing but a minimum amount of time has been spent by the, we can say, the product on each station or product on each station. This is called cycle time.
Now, why this is a very important factor. This is a very important factor. As I have said, the cycle time is nothing but the minimum amount of time has been spent by each product, or the processing time we can say, on the each station. So this is given by this is denoted by the CD. This is defined by production time available. Production time available divided by the say total number of production, total production, total production. So, or we can say this is the desired output or desired output. So this is the cycle time. So now we'll see an example. We'll write down the an example. Write one example here. The speedy pizza is revamping its order. So write down, note down the problem. The speedy pizza palace is revamping its order, processing and pizza making procedure. The demand for pizza is 120 per night, that is from 5 p.m. to 1 a.m. In order to deliver fresh pizza fast, 6 element must be completed. Now we will see that 6 element. So this is work element, second is residence, third is time, and this time is in minutes. So this is A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay. 6 elements. So to deliver a pizza, the 6 element must be completed, or this procedure must be completed. So first is A. A is to receive order. Receive order. B is shape to give shape, shape given we can say. Third is C, that is prepare toppings, prepare toppings. D is assemble pizza,
assemble pizza is baked pizza and after baking it is ready for delivery and deliver pizza. So these are the six operations are carried out for delivering pizza speedily. So we'll now see the precedence. So sorry, this is A. Now you will find the sequence of operations. So your first operation is to receive the order. So this is operation A. So this A, after A there are again the processing, that is shape given. The second operation is shape given, and for again we will see the time for receiving the order. The time required is say 2 minutes, and when after receiving the order this A comes in front of B, so after A the operation is this B on operation A, on A the shape given, and that requires again 1 minute. At the same time the prepare topping, so again that operation is on A. So the time required is that 2 minutes, and then is B, that is assemble pizza. So the precedence are B and C, and it requires 3 minutes, and after that pizza baking is there and it requires 3 minutes, and the last operation is E, precedence is E, yeah, and requires operation is 3 minutes. So how to solve this problem? Now while solving this problem there are number of steps to solve this problem. So total there are 6 steps. So first step is to solve this problem is, So I'll rub it first. Now we'll see the step to solve this problem or procedure. We can say procedure to solve line balancing problem. So to solve this problem the first step is to draw and label precedence diagram. So first step is to draw and label precedence diagram. The second step is calculate desired